Use headphones for best experience. Thanks for your fantastic support. This is going to be a map reading video. I'm going to read from this historical atlas by William R. Shepherd. I think it's a really beautiful atlas. It's the fourth edition, revised in 1924. Would like to jump to page 78. We will take a look at Central Europe in 1378. What the map then. So here you see what's today part of Denmark in the north, Germany in the center, Switzerland, Austria, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Poland. Northern Italy, France, Belgium, Luxembourg, the Netherlands. Croatia, small part of Bosnia, yeah. To the very southeast of this map, Slovenia, Hungary, small part of England. as you can see, it's a really complicated map. A lot of independent states, kingdoms, different kinds of nations. Then it stands for the Archbishopric, and AB is Abbacy, B is a bishopric, C is a county, D is a duchy, L is a land graviate. Is a margravate. P stands for principality. V stands for viscounty. This pale pink color stands for the Luxembourg Dominion. This light green color stands for the Wittelbach Bavarian line. No, sorry. The light green and the darker green is the Wittelbach Dominion. The light green is for the Bavarian line, and the dark green is for the Palatinate line. This apricot or salmon color is for the Habsburg Dominion. This purple color is for the ecclesiastical states. Never heard this word before. Ecclesiastical states. Exclusive of the ecclesiastical electorate. This orange color is used for the imperial cities, boundary of the empire, I guess the Holy Roman Empire. Castle and monastery. The pink border given to the areas of Brabant and Limburg indicates that these lands belonged in 1378 to the Duchess of Luxembourg. The dominions of the Visconti are shown at their extent in 1395. The areas in the empire left in color were divided into petty states. Sites of important historical events, thus asterisk. Thank you. start to take a look here in the very center of this map. So here we have the county of Nassau, east of the Rhine River. We have Frankfurt, a main river, so this must be Frankfurt am Main today. Here we have Hesse, the city of Marburg. Nassau is the city in the county of Nassau, labeled here. And we have the Weser River. Germany, I guess. What's this here? Land gravate of Hesse, perhaps. Land gravate of Hesse. Area. Here we have the Duchy of Westphalia. Westphalia I recognize from the something I learned in the history piece of Westphalia. B of Münster, Bishopric of Münster. And here we have the Ems River. Münster, ending up here in Friesland, in the North Sea. We have the Rhine River, and along the west coast of the Rhine River we have the Archbishopric of Cologne, County of Berg. We have Bonn, old capital of West Germany. We have the county of Cleves, and here the Duchy of Gelderland. bishopric of Utrecht. And the bishopric of Münster. The Ems River again. Friesland. So, Zeeland, all these islands, the Duchy of Brabant, both Brussels. Says Calais to England. Just the same color as the Kingdom of England here, so I guess Calais was English at this point. Not French. Here it says Kingdom of France. We have the Seine River and Paris. The Duchy of Normandy. County of Artois. Here we have a big duchy, the Duchy of Luxembourg, between the Meuse River and the Moselle River. River. Moselle River. Here, along the Moselle River, on both sides of it, we have the Archbishopric of Trèves and the city of Trèves. Palatinate of the Rhine, so this green area here, and this orange colored area here. I think it says worms. Worms. And that should be an imperial city. It's like Metz by the Moselle River. Let's see if we can find more orange areas. Imperial cities. Dortmund. Bremen. We have Mecklenburg, which is north, along the north coast of Germany, and the county of Holstein. I think I've talked a bit about Mecklenburg, Holstein in the previous video. My drawing map of Germany video. And here it says Pomerania. And Principality of Rügen. Schwerin, Walter River, here we have some information about Poland and Lithuania under the same ruling house in 1386. Domain of the Teutonic Order. The Königsberg. see here, it should be the electorate of Saxony. And it says just that here on the map as well, electorate of Saxony. Along the Elbe River. And I wonder what this light red area is about to show. Okay, it's a Habsburg dominion part of it. And here it says Landgraviate of Thuringia, Thüringen. Osterland, Margaret of Osterland. And Margaret of Meissen. Kingdom. To me it looks like basically western part of today's Czech Republic. It's a kingdom of Bohemia. Here we have Upper Palatinate. Distinct colors here. Not sure how to read this properly. But this green color should mean Wittelbach dominions, Palatinate line. This area here is the Duchy of Bavaria, Munich. And the river of Danube. Straubing. Duchy of Bavaria. And if we follow Danube River to the east, we have the Duchy of Austria. And the Duchy of Styria. It says something about Habsburg here. Habsburg 1282. Duchy of Carinthia, County of Tyrol, all these have the same color here, this orange color. Wonder if I can find Munich here in the Duchy of Bavaria, Munich. Have you seen it yet? Yeah, there it is, Munich. Yeah. Here's the Archbishopric of Salzburg. I guess the most messy part of this map, I believe, is this part. So many small states, duchies, counties, whatever they're called. Here in the Alps, between the Danube River and the Rhine River. But here's something. Quite a large area here. It's the county of Württemberg. And a lot of these orange imperial cities here, located here. Right. Now we're in Switzerland. Metz, Strasbourg, Bishopric of Strasbourg. So today we find the border between Germany and Switzerland here somewhere. Bishopric of Trent. Here we have Italy. Very northern part of Italy. The Alps. Dominions of the Visconti. Quite a large area here. Milan. Duchy of either it's dominions of the Visconti or Duchy of Visconti. This is a bit unclear, I guess, on this map. And the Po River. Northern Italy. Papal State, Ravenna, Ferrara, Venice, and the Venetian Republic. And it says here, this, all this coast here belongs to the Venetian Republic. Now, Croatia, Slovenia, okay, and Italy. We move a bit to the west. Savoy or Savoie. Free County of Burgundy. It's an orange area around the city of Besançon. The Rhône River, Lyon. So the Duchy of Burgundy was French at this point. But then we also had the Free County of Burgundy to the west, to the east. Today, I guess part of France. Because France is, I would say France border today. So that showed rain. It's French today. This part of Kingdom of France is called Dauphiny to France in 1349. The County of Provence here at the French Riviera, Marseille. Republic of Genoa. Here there are a lot of imperial cities, according to this legend. They're marked in orange color. This is a larger area. It's called the Burgraviat of Eger River, the city of Eger, this area is called Pleissner Land. Dresden in Margaret of Meissen. So something about Luxembourg. Luxembourg, Bohemian, 1320. Görlitz. Here we have a large duchy, it's a duchy of Silesia. In today's Poland. the Margravate of Moravia in today's Czech Republic, to Luxembourg in 1310. I didn't know Luxembourg was so vast at this time. Today, I think Luxembourg is quite interesting because it kind of reminds us of all these duchies and independent kingdoms from this time, medieval time. Still a small country here between France, Belgium, Germany, Netherlands. Have I read this already? The Bishopry of Würzburg along this river, main river, probably. And I mentioned the Archbishopric of Cologne. Here also it says the County of Cologne. To the east of the Rhine. The Archbishopric was to the west. So, as you can see, it's not super easy to navigate through Central Europe in 1378. On other maps from the same time, here the Great Schism, 1378 to 1417, France in 1453. This area, this whole area is referred to as the Empire. Castile and Leon, Kingdom of Aragon, Kingdom of Portugal, Kingdom of Granada, Kingdom of Naples, Kingdom of Hungary, Kingdom of Poland, Kingdom of Sweden, Kingdom of Denmark, Kingdom of England, Kingdom of Scotland, Ireland. So, Kingdom of Castile and Leon, wasn't long before these two kingdoms united into Spain in the late 15th century. Kingdom of Aragon and Kingdom of Castile and Leon. Yes. There are some really interesting maps over today's Spain or to the Iberian Peninsula between 910 to 1492. And this grey area to the south is the Moorish area. Long history in the Iberian Peninsula. From, I think, 700s to 1400s. Yeah. You can see Spain 1212 to 1492. All that's left of the Moorish kingdom is the Kingdom of Granada. And you can see the Kingdom of Aragon to the east. Let's zoom in a bit. Kingdom of Aragon with Barcelona, Valencia, Ebro River here. I think Ebro River was given the name to Iberian Peninsula by the Greeks in the past. Kingdom of Castile and Leon. If you remember the Texas video posted recently, I was drawing the flag of Spain, old flag of Spain, where you could see the lion and the Castile. Separate parts of the flag. Kingdom of Portugal. Looks just like it does today. From this point. A bit earlier you could see here, Spain in 1150. You could see that the dominion of the Almohads included south of Portugal, south of the Tagus River, with Lisbon just at the southern tip of the Kingdom of Portugal. Here's Coimbra, Oporto, and you can see Leon, kingdoms of Leon and Castile, slightly different color here. Leon's a bit darker red and Castile a bit lighter. Also here in the legend you can see kingdoms of Leon and Castile, dark, light, red. Kingdom of Aragon, Kingdom of Navarre, Madrid. It's a quite small city. I guess Toledo was the biggest city minus in this area. Saragossa, and the independent county of Barcelona, Kingdom of Aragon, Kingdom of Navarre, Kingdoms Leon. Leon is the greater part here, and Castile, I guess, is this smaller part. Seville, Lisbon, Murcia, Valencia, Saragossa, Kingdom of Leon, County of Barcelona, the Balearic Islands, both Spain and Central Europe, I guess. It's a lot of interesting and complicated history. Not easy to keep track on it when you flip through a historical atlas like this. Very beautiful with all these colors, I guess. But I think that's it for this video. Hope you found it relaxing. So much for your support, for subscribing, leaving comments, and liking the video. For your support on Tingles and PayPal, Patreon. Soon.